You want to fill an entire artboard with a single shape, maybe a circle, a star, a single colour that is, orange, green, etc. Well, how to do that? I'm just going to go over here to the circle. I could use star, any other shape, and just quickly create that. Now, key panels for this, view, and go down to studio, and there's like assets, very useful, swatches, symbols, etc. And you can see them here. Now, I want to turn this design, one that's currently selected, into a symbol. Go to the symbols panel and there's an option here, create. Long as it's selected, that's a key thing. So click create and it will become a symbol. And you can see what happens there. Over here in the layers, that's become symbol, and beneath it is the ellipse. And this is useful because I can then change that later. So with this symbol, I can duplicate it, or I could just drag as well. So I could drag from the symbols, or I can just duplicate it on the artboard. I'm going to do that. So select the move tool and then hold down the Alt or Option key and drag. And then you've got another design there. You can resize it, rotate it, whatever. Obviously with a circle, doesn't matter. And again, repeat that multiple times so you can just fill it and you can fill rapidly the whole artboard using this approach. However, make it even quicker, select all of those, and you can select, and you can see what happens there. All the symbols there are all selected. You can hold down the Alt or Option key again and duplicate it. Now I want to avoid the edges because I want to use this design later in something else. So I just want to avoid the edges. You don't have to, it's up to you. But you can see you can duplicate this design multiple times. Hold down the Alt or Option key, that's on the keyboard, or use various, one thing that's weird with this, there's no option for duplicate in the layer menu. Never understood that, very strange. However, Alt or Option key is much better. Some applications have got a duplicate in there and then others don't, like obviously Affinity Designer. However, what you can do, you resize those and you can also select other ones. So let's just select those and then resize. And they're all still symbols. That's a key thing. So they're all still symbols and you can position them anywhere across this document. And you can also move them, of course, individually. So you can decide, you know what, I don't want that one there. I can put that there and so on. So you can see you can fill the entire design, select a few more, and repeat that. Now it does get a bit slower, notice. Also, but because I'm recording this, so I think that's to be fair, it's not normally this slow when I'm just doing it normally. So now I've got this document entirely filled, this artboard. What I can do, I can go to any of these symbols. So I'm just gonna go to one of these symbols. And of course it's one right at the bottom, maybe that symbol. So that symbol, and I can then resize that, move it around. Now that doesn't modify any of the other designs. That's the key thing. However, you can expand it. You just go over here in the layers panel, expand it, and you can select this ellipse and you can right click. See the duplicates here, not in layer. Very strange. Don't understand that. Please put in the comments if you know, maybe I'm just doing it wrong and there should be a duplicate there. Very strange that. However, duplicate. And you can see what happens, you get this duplicate. Now it's relative to the one I was selecting. So you see, when I move that, you can see what happens. You get this weird sort of effect. All of them get this design. So you can create, we lovely if there was an animation feature in thing, because you could animate this and create some interesting design. And you can resize that. You can see that they all resize. And also you go and change, you know what, I want different colors because I don't want it all the same color, but I can do that. So I can position that. And they're all relative to each other. So that there, if I go to that one and move that, they will move. So they all move while I'm in that symbol, which I think is quite nice. Very useful, and you can resize, of course. So you can resize them all inside it. Outside doesn't make a difference, but inside with it selected, you can. And you can change the color again. So if you decide, you know what, red. Also what you can do, right click again, duplicate. And then you can say, oh, I'll resize that again. And you can see that they all move as well. I think it's quite nice. I like doing that. Obviously, I've got nothing better to do with my time than to do all those sort of things. However, once you've done that, now I don't want to go over the edge. That's a key thing that I would like to avoid. And now I've got my symbol there. I've got a slightly more complicated symbol than I had before. Now I can come out of there again and I can now duplicate the symbol. And again, I can resize it and it doesn't matter. It doesn't affect all the others. Duplicate other things and I can move that there. And of course I can select those and drag that around and resize. And you can see the general gist of the thing. Now I've got this really nice design. Of course, what you can then do, you can think, you know what, I want to save it now, because it's not much use if you don't save it. And you can select all of them. You can see, select all. There's a great option here of assets. So assets now, I've got here, I've created a category called Andrew, create new category there. And also you can create a subcategory if you want to do that. But I like to have a separate sort of category there. You've got assets and you've got those ones there. So just gonna go with there and Andrew. With this one, just go there, and now all of those are selected. Don't do that. You don't want to do it, because you can do it, but what will happen? It will create lots of entries. And I found that to my cost. So best thing to do is go to layer and group, and it all become a single group. Now go to the assets. It's a pity it doesn't actually offer at that point. It'd be nice if it turned around and said, you reshore, remember to group them, because it does actually just generate lots of entries. So now go to add from selection, and now you've got your entry there. I say before it would have just generated lots and lots of different shapes, and that would have been takes. Not only that, there's no delete option other than deleting the entire category. You can't, you want to delete them, you have to delete them one by one. Long time. However, you got that asset. And of course, with asset, what you can do, you can drag it over. Just duplicate it. You don't have to do that, of course, but I'm just saying you can go to the assets and you can see what happens. It just generates even more. I'm just going to undo add symbol instant. I don't want to do that. But you can see the result there, all these symbols again there. Got lots and lots of design. And again, you can still continue to manipulate the design. So you can go there and you can still move them around within that group. And also you've got them stored. However, also, if you want to export them, say you want to save them to a PNG file, well, you can do that. Go to File and Export, and I want it PNG, fine, whole document, fine. I'm not certain why it doesn't default to whole document, since that is the document, might as well default that. And you've got various options here, Export, and I'm going to save it to spots. Obviously PNG, but spots one. Because I've already got the other one, and I'm just going to always away. It's always move that out of the way. Save. So you've just saved it, exported it to a file, a PNG file, and then you can use it in other projects. But of course, that isn't the end of it. So you've got this layers here. You can expand it again, and you've got this design here. But you think, you know what? I don't want circles. Decided I don't want circles. Well, what you can do? You can go to here, maybe a star. Obviously star there, or triangle. It's a triangle. Let's just create a triangle. So I create a triangle. You see the triangle gets created. Now it depends which one I've got. See, that's the key thing. If you're going to select, so there's the symbol. So don't create it up there if that's not what you want. So select that. You can see the bounding box there. Now within that, what I want to do is create that shape. Now that's all relative again to those shapes. And you can see those designs there. However, I don't want the ellipse. Don't want them anymore, so I can just say delete and delete and delete. Now, instead of circles, you've got triangles. And again, you can do exactly the same as there. You've got that design selected, and I can add another triangle there. And of course, I don't want that color, so let's go to the swatches. If I can find it, there it is. So swatches, and I can add another one. Again, relative to that design, maybe add another one, blue, and then another one there, maybe yellow, and so on and so on. You could, or another, different blue, red, etc. You can change your mind and just change it at any time. And of course, you can always rotate it. So you can always go there, and you can then create different designs like that. So you can see you can create all kinds of field designs, and you can still then go there to the symbol, and now move it around, hold down the Alt or Option key, and duplicate that design. So you can fill the design. So if you suddenly see you've got some spaces like I have over here, and I don't want that. I want to fill it with this design. I can now just fill them very quickly like that. And again, at any point, you can always decide, you know what, I want to rotate it. You can rotate the whole thing. You don't have to keep it the same angle. Resize that, duplicate, hold down the Alt or Option key, and you can fill it very quickly with all kinds of designs. And again, once you're happy with that, go to File, and export, And in this case, again, exactly the same as well. PNG always goes back to ARTBOARD, whole document, export. And again, I'm going to go with triangles. So you've got triangles there. And create vast number of background designs very quick. And of course, it doesn't have to be just circles and stars and whatever. You can make far more complex designs than that inside these symbols. So you could just put literally anything. Obviously, the more complex the designs, then it's going to be slower. So if you create a very complex design, it's, you know, it's not going to be as quick. And again, what you can do, you can always change it. You can go to the gradient tool, say, and then just add a gradient. Modify that and just add a gradient. All kinds of different designs can be created using this approach. Hope you found this of interest. Any comments below, please put them below, because it's always great to hear something I've done wrong, something I've done right. Thank you much. Bye.